neutral side action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Nebraska has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. Sends it sailing downfield. And down he goes at the 17. UCLA's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. I mean, you can do that as a quarterback, and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Got it. And he goes down quickly. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
He's out to the 30. Gets out to around the 32.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run. And that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Goes over the middle. The tailback's got it. And down he goes around the 38-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run. So the halfback gets some decent yards and a first down.
I don't think there's a coach in the world who wouldn't be happy with getting 5 yards a carry.
Gets out to around the 48.
Brings him down. That's a deep 9 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Takes the ball right. He's taken down at the 46. It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Brought down at the 37.
That brings up second and 1.
Made the 37-yard line. And he's immediately tackled. Down after a nice run up the middle.
That makes it second and 6.
Up the middle for a nice gain. Positive yardage.
Well, that's the second time that this defense has given up a first down on third down. You work so hard as a defense to get an offense to third down. When you get them there, you've got to be able to have somebody step up and make a big play, whether it's a defensive tackle slipping through a block, a linebacker shooting a gap, a defender in the secondary that's able to make a play on a football. Somebody's got to make a play, and that's what winning, the difference between winning a football game and losing is how you play on third down.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal.
Gain 12 yards.
Roger, Roger.
That makes it first and goal.
Hey, Mike's the team.
Nice run there.
Mike's the team.
tackled just outside the goal line. He's scrambling, decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. Short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. A long 17-play, 81-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So our score, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Makes it out to about the 43. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From their own 43-yard line. First down. Has some daylight. He makes his way to about the 48.
That's good for gain in 9 yards. That makes it second and two.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Now he's scrambling. And they got him. What a play by the freshman linebacker.
There's really nothing he could have done against a rush like that.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. He makes it to the 28-yard line. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 7-0, Bruins. Ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Oh yeah, I'm coming. Oh yeah, I'm coming.
UCLA up 7 points. And they'll bring him down behind the line. And they'll lose a yard there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 23-yard line, third down. Out of bounds, the 26-yard line. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Tackle at the 40-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook.
Tackle at the 50-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. And they make the stop around the 37-yard line. Second down. That's a great tackle at the 33. Out of bounds at the 19-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 19. Inside the 10. And he's got him again. And he's taken down at the 7. On the run, room around the corner, and he's gonna run this one in. Touchdown. No one could break clear, so the QB decided to run it in.
You've got to like it when your leader takes things into his own hands, especially down inside the 10.
The extra point to tie this game up, and he adds the extra point. A 7-play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
We get a tie game at 7-7. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 24. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. He's tackled at about the 23-yard line.
When this guy gets his arms around the ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 23-yard line. Bring him down around the 31-yard line. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Made at the 40. Well, really a defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style game plan. I think if I were the offensive coordinator, take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. The 46-yard line. It's first down. Great concentration to haul it in. He's taken down around the
3-yard line. Hand off, and he's met immediately. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Nebraska is going to use their first time out of the half here. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. The 10, and a quick throw. And that sets them up for the first and goal.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
He's going to try and scramble. He was lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage on that scramble. We're at the 1 minute mark, first half. Pitches it, he's got the corner, dives forward. With some movement on the line. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Well, let's see what they do here. It's third and goal from the 6. Now he tries to buy some time. He's wrapped up for the sack. Just an excellent individual effort to make the play there.
I have to tell you, for being so young, he looks pretty good out there, linebacker.
Nebraska is looking to go up by 3. He gets it up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
We played a half. The Cornhuskers lead 10-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Nebraska has a 3-point lead. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on their own 27. And they got him for a loss. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Brought down right around the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, first down. Around the corner. He's at the 40. Tackle made at about the 27-yard line. So we've got a first down after a great running play. Nebraska is up a field goal. He scrambles, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's tackled at the 18. They'll line it up again on third down. Gets out to around the 9. And this is the 8th play of the drive. He's out of bounds around the 6-yard line.
That's good for 3 yards. That brings him second and goal.
From the 6-yard line, it's second down. Tackle at the 3-yard line. Tenth play of the drive. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big runs.
So the score now, 17-7. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. Across the 30. The 50. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Bruins. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes
into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
Nebraska holds a field goal lead.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Scrambling around. Excellent open field tackle. To defend.
This is a perfect illustration of how to run the option, and it was perfect enough to get the first right there.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. He's got an opening. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Outside for a nice gain.
That brings him second and five.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop at the 40-yard line. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. Nebraska is up by three. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down around the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, first down. He might have a chance. Makes his way out to about the 15. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Strike to his receiver, no good. So with one quarter remaining, the Cornhuskers lead 17-14. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He steps out at the 9. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Breaks one and scores.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he tacks on the extra point. So an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Throw to the back, it's incomplete.
Sometimes when you throw it that hard, you can't control the accuracy all that well. He'll get it under control, though, in time.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. He's tackled around the 30-yard line. It out right to the running back. He tackles him for a loss. The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. Made at the 40.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They'll bring him down around the 36-yard line. And 10. Ball on the 36. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. 2-yard gain on the quarterback keeper.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
Yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Taken down at the 18-yard line.
The option's one of the more difficult plays to defend. The defense went after the quarterback, which left the running back with plenty of room.
Quick throw to the tight end. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. The Bruins call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Shoved out of bounds around the 1-yard line. Now, Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Point. A 7-play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Great concentration to haul it in.
The 10. Touchdown!
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
Once he got the ball, he did all the heavy lifting to take it to the house. He makes the PAT. Should pretty much do it for him.
Well, at least these guys showed great effort. My hat goes off to these young men for playing so hard out there today.
This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
From the 30-yard line, it's first down.
There he goes.
He gets out to about the 11-yard line. Got a first and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He'll go down to one knee. This one's in the books, and our final score, 31-21, Nebraska. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.